Do you want to be using tap water for a hydroponic system? When we're talking about tap water, we're talking about the additives and impurities that are in your tap water that can directly affect the nutrients and supplements that you're feeding your plants. We know that the water coming out of our taps isn't pure, and we can confirm this by using a TDS meter and measuring the total dissolved solids. Normally, we're going to see a number between 200 and 300 ppm, and that can vary a little bit depending on where you live and where your water's coming from. Pure water has a TDS reading of zero, and this is what all your hydroponic nutrients are based off of when you're mixing them. When you add nutrients based off your label, it's telling you what you should expect for a ppm based on the volume that you're mixing. This is assuming, again, that you're using pure water, water that has a TDS reading of zero ppm. Now let's say we're using straight tap water that has a reading of 200 ppm. Does that mean you're going to mix less nutrient to take into account for the 200 that's already in your tap water? Or do you just mix according to the label and assume that your water is zero? Usually we end up doing the latter and we end up overcompensating when we're mixing our nutrients. Ideally, when we're mixing our nutrients, we want that water to be as pure as possible. But without reverse osmosis or other filters, is this even achievable? When we're talking about tap water, one of the things we're concerned about is the chlorine that's in the water. And normally what we do if chlorine's in the water is you put that water into a bucket and you let it evaporate for a day. But what you might not know is your water might contain chloramine instead of chlorine. And with chloramine, you can't simply let it evaporate over time. My area uses chloramine, and that's because it services a lot of rural areas and that water has to travel a long distance. So they want to make sure that that water is safe by the time it gets to the end of the line. Don't let that worry you though. Chloramine can still be removed from your tap water, although it does take a little bit more work and it is a little bit more expensive. There are chemical water conditioners, RO systems, and other high quality filters that can let you end up with some really nice water to use for your plants. Hard water could also pose a problem for your plants. When we're talking about extremely hard water, your plants are at risk due to an overabundance of minerals that they only need in a small amount to thrive. Yes, your plants need things like calcium and magnesium to grow, but from the tap, it could be either, like I said, an overabundance, or it could be the opposite end of the spectrum, where the molecule is actually too large for that plant to uptake. So can you use tap water for hydroponics? Sure, why not? I mean, ideally, you're going to start with your water between 2 to 300 ppm. Maybe you're going to try to take out some of the chlorine and chloramine, but you're going to have a really good water to start with. The plants you're growing have an extremely strong desire to propagate, grow, and seed. And I don't feel like using tap water is going to stop them from doing that. It surely won't kill them. I think the reason why it becomes such a hot topic in the hydroponic world is because when we're talking hydroponics, we're talking about controlled environments. We're talking about being able to control the light, the water, the nutrient, everything that plant needs to grow. So when you add in a variable like tap water where you don't necessarily know what's in it, you've all of a sudden lost control of the growing environment. And I think that's where it becomes an issue. Ultimately, it's going to come down to you and what you deem is the most convenient and cost effective for your garden. At the end of the day, you're going to have vegetables, fruit, flowers, whatever it is that you're growing. Just be happy with your results and keep on growing. Thanks for watching.